we've been getting an overwhelming amount of positive feedback from doing the hikes and showing all the beautiful stuff. Once again, we have to say goodbye to the doggies. They can't come with us on these.
Worry about us. Do I look sad enough?
All right, today we're going to go on another quick hike, not too far, but there's some really cool stuff around this one.
And you have your green shirt on.
I don't. I have my Malibu shirt on. Don't step in that. It might break your flak. Today we are going back to where we attempted to go the other day.
Oh, right.
It's called Solstice Canyon. What's at the end, Kathie?
Well, it depends on how far you go as to what you call the end. Because I don't know
where the end is. Where are we going to eat lunch?
I don't know that either.
Blue-eyed terror. All of this belonged to one family back in the day, with the exclusion of these bathrooms. This was their driveway, basically.
Yeah.
It was a mile and a half driveway along the river over here. Really, truly beautiful. Original horse trough. Take a sip.
That is freaking cool.
I don't think I want to drink out of this.
I think there's something crawling in there. What is it?
Structure up here. We're going to try to go see this. I'm not sure we can get up there, but it was built in 1901 by Henry Keller, and then 2 years later, it was a wood cabin. 2 years later, it burned down, and then he built another one out of stone and tin, and that lasted up until 2007, and then that one burned down. Outdoor kitchen and stove. Selfie time. That was awesome.
That's not even the house we were talking about.
No. Only the
first one.
Yeah, yeah, we're about halfway there up to the other house. But that was the original Keller Lodge, a hunting lodge. This next one, that's gonna blow your mind. Thank you. and she goes down.
By the way, I did not see you do it.
No, I didn't do it, did I?
No. Tofu, rice, quinoa, and peas, and a serrano chili, and probably some garlic. Whew. Oh, and mushrooms.
This whole homestead was done by the architect Paul R. Williams, and the owner was Fred Roberts and his family, and they commissioned it in 1931, was it?
No, 50. He started buying the land in the 30s.
And then it had some elaborate pumps set up so that no forest fires could come in and destroy it, but then when he died, they weren't maintained, and they lost the fire in what year?
82.
It's a bummer because it's gorgeous up here.
Oh.
Thank you. get back. I'm stepping in the sun here, but there's one thing I want to show you guys before we go back. Right up there is a very interesting house. It's completely abandoned, although no, there is a guy living there, but it's empty. It was built many years ago, and it looks like something way out of the future. Check this out. So while we were hiking, Nissan snuck in and left me this little toy. Right there. My stop motion experiment. Pretty awesome hike today, and very cool to be able to come back to the pad and see that Nissan sitting there waiting, if I do say so myself, and I do. But something else kind of cool that kind of showed up today, I got an email from one of our favorite mascot clients, Buddy Cruz. If you've never seen Buddy Cruz, I'm going to put the website right here. Buddy Cruz is a really an amazing program for kids and adults of all ages. Challenged teens and adults who want to have a really good time on a cruise, and that's what they do. And we created the mascot. His name is Buddy. And over the years, we did Buddy, you know, quite a few years ago, but over the years, Buddy does some interesting things. And every now and then, our client Pam sends us some fun things that Buddy is into. But this time in particular, she sent over a video of Buddy doing something truly spectacular. I'm not even sure how to describe this, but I don't believe I've ever seen a mascot do this type of thing. Check this out. So what you're seeing here is Buddy taking off vertically. Now, I've seen ships do lots of things in my day, but I can't say I've ever seen a ship fly. And I have to say, Buddy, you're doing a pretty phenomenal job. So who says that ships can't fly? I mean, ships have to stay in the water. You know, if the Titanic could have done this, they could have raised out. You know, they wouldn't have hit the iceberg, and then history would have been completely different. Thank you, Pam, for sending that. And make sure that a big hello to Buddy and to everybody on the cruise. We love you guys. You guys are awesome. Okay, that's all I got for today. Thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to subscribe. Hang out with us. We got all kinds of cool stuff coming, especially tomorrow. Tomorrow, I'm headed to the Automobile Driving Museum. Going to be doing a book signing. Going to have this car on display. So if you need something to do, come and hang out with us. And if you're dealing with any challenges, keep your chin up, because awesomeness is right around the corner. You know it is.